Hey folks, Nick Wheeler here again at Wheeler Custom Knives. So in this video, I'm going to be discussing how I do a domed and polished pin through my knife handles. First thing I want to say is I want to give credit and thanks and appreciation to my friend and master smith extraordinaire, John White. Back in 2010, I was trying to do domed pins and I really wasn't very happy with the results I was getting. And so I called John, kind of begging him on the phone, which wasn't necessary. He very graciously shared his knowledge and experience with me, and that made a tremendous difference to help me get started. And 4 years later, I've done at least a couple hundred domed pins, and the process I use is still pretty much the same as what I started with. And it's not exactly how John told me, because I had different stuff, and so I had to sort of adjust my process to what I had and what I could make work for me in my shop. And that's just how any of this stuff is for any of us. A domed pin, for me, it's one of the last things I do to a knife. And so you really want to be careful with it. You know, it's an easy place to really screw up a knife. I have some fixtures and a little tooling stuff that I made to help me, so I feel more confident when I get to that step that I'm going to be able to do it and get the results I want consistently. And with a lot of this stuff, guys like to give me flack. They say, oh, well, Wheeler will build a fixture to build a fixture. But the truth is, I only make gadgets and fixtures and stuff when I think that it has the potential to help me. So it either make a better product, make it more efficiently, or consistently. And that's definitely the case with these things, for the way that I dome a pin. A lot of guys, I mean, fairly traditionally, the approach is to slide the pin through the hole and then just use a hammer and anvil of some sort and flip the thing back and forth and dome it. And now obviously that has worked for a lot of guys for a long time, but it's also really easy to screw the knife up. And this approach that I use, still easy to screw the knife up, but I think less so. I think it's easier to get a consistent outcome. And so if I can invest a little bit of time and make a couple little gadgets that over the course of years are gonna cut down on that anxiety for me and make things easier, I'm all for that. So you know, I do that. And these things that I use for the pin process, they're real simple. I mean, if you can make a knife, you can make these things that I use. So if you stick around for a minute, I'll show you the fixture, the little tools I use, and we'll go ahead and put a pin in a knife and get it all finished off, and hopefully that'll help some guys out and it'll be good to go. So let's get started.
Now most of my handles, the domed pins, start like this. We are at the glue up stage right now. This is a fighter. The handle's all fit up and I just assembled everything with acroglass, just 1/16 416 stainless, just like the actual pin will be. But what we've got going here, I used to glue everything together and then drill the hole, but the problem with that is even if you have a dead soft tang, when a 16th inch bit goes through the wood and then hits the tang, it wants to wander and it'll wallow out the hole and it just makes a big mess of things. And the other thing, I try to fit my handles fairly close, and so it's not a big old sloppy fit in there. And so when you do that, if you don't have some kind of hole like this, you can put epoxy in there, you can get an airlock where the handle actually won't even fit all the way up tight like it's supposed to. So there's sort of a double benefit of that. So we're gonna put a release agent on this and put this through the handle, and then that's of course gonna go through the tang. There's a slightly oversized hole through the tang, and we're gonna let the pin sit in there while the epoxy cures. Now, I used to use wax. Lately I've been using the this petroleum jelly. For bedding a handle, I think wax works a lot better, but for whatever reason, the petroleum jelly, Vaseline, it seems to work better for this dummy pin, and I don't really know why, but so put some on the pin, put some around the hole in the block, and then, like I said, this is all clamped up tight, and this hole runs all the way through, so I'm just gonna push it through there. When it comes out the other side, it's gonna push some epoxy out, so you gotta wipe that off, and then just to be on the safe side, smear a little bit more of this petroleum jelly around the pin, just to make sure that the epoxy is not gonna adhere to that pin and lock it in place. Because like I said, we're gonna pull this pin out before the epoxy is fully cured. We just gotta let that sit for now, and we'll come back to it later. To get the pin out, there usually be a little bit of a bond, even though we put the Vaseline on there. And so I'll take a hammer and just tap this. You don't wanna wail on it. A swift little tap, and that'll break it free. Little pair of vice grips, and you can twist it out. And so that is why that's why I call it a dummy pin, is this just a temporary one that goes in there for that purpose. And so now we've got a nice 1/16 inch hole cavity that runs all the way through, and we don't have any pin that's going to hamper our shaping process. But then once this is all shaped, then we can go ahead and get started on putting a nice pretty finished pin in here that will, but it's also going to be a mechanical fastener, so it's a win-win. So it's time to shape this thing. Okay, so let's take a look at these super high-tech tools that I use for this. Obviously a hammer, and then in order to fixture the blade and not have to hold on to the knife with one hand and hammer with the other, this is the sort of the foundation. This is the fixture to securely hold the knife while we're doming the pin, and it gets held right here. This is just a piece of heavy flat bar, and it's got another piece of heavy flat bar that I welded on at 90 degrees, and then another piece of heavy bar stock that is attached to that with two quarter 20 machine screws. This is, as you can tell, this is not a precision instrument. The knife is held in here by the Ricasso, and you do one side and then you flip it over to touch up the other side. And you know, this is pretty sloppy. I don't have, you know, dowel pins or anything like that in here. It just has to securely hold the blade. It's more important that this is oversized and beefy like this than it be a precision tool. And then to support the pin while we're hammering on the top side of it, I made this little adjustable post anvil, is really what it amounts to. It's just a heavy block of bar stock. This is the same size that the KMG tooling arms are. I've got a 3/8-16 stainless steel bolt that I drilled and tapped a hole in here for, so it threads down in there. And I've got a lock washer and a nut, and then I put this little sliding T-handle through here, like you see on a C-clamp, just so I would have, I'd need one less wrench to use this thing. And then, as you can tell, I rounded the bolt head off and polished it. Now, something that comes up on the forum sometimes is this topic right here. I used a diamond burr and I put a little cupped divot right there, and it's really not necessary. I mean, it doesn't hurt anything, but the main thing is that you want to round this head of this bolt off like I did here and polish it, because you only want this thing to be making contact with the end of your pin. If this is raised up and making contact, the bolt head is making contact with your handle, you're gonna mar your handle up. And then something that I added just, I guess within the last year, I drilled two flat bottom holes in here and I super glued two rare earth magnets in there. And the reason for that, if you raise this bolt up, the little post anvil, if you raise this up to support the bottom side of the pin, if you jack this thing up high enough that it's pushing the knife real hard so that it's holding this in place, I think you're exerting a lot of forces on the knife that just aren't necessary. But so to help me just sort of keep this in place, those magnets, and it's not anything crazy, I mean I break it free pretty easily, but it's it just helps keep it where I want it. And then moving on, these were very much based on Mr. John White's teachings over the phone. I went to the hardware store and I got a set of four relatively inexpensive nail sets. Now, in the 4 years since then, I've made a few punches myself, but I always go back and use these. So, you know, stick with what works. The two that I use hands down the most are these ones. And they're just, I rounded, ground the ends down and rounded them off and then put a mirror polish on them. Now this one, it might look pointy on here, but it's not. It's about a 16th of an inch at the end and just no sharp edges, just nicely polished. Then, and this is for pinpointing your force on, and then for just the general mushrooming of the pin is this one. And this one's closer to an 1/8 inch on the end. Same thing. Rounded over, mirror polished, no sharp edges. Now, just for S's and G's, I'll explain these two. These I thought were this brilliant idea that I had. I took a diamond spherical burr and I made these so that they're cupped on the end. And my thought process was that this, once you got the pin close, you could use these to dial in the shape. And in theory, it works okay. In application, not so much. It's very easy because you have a sharp edge because of this being cupped. You have a fairly sharp edge around there. And so if you cant this just a little bit too much when you're going around the pin, that sharp edge will cut right into your handle material and it'll leave a halo around your pin, which looks like crap. We don't want to do that. So I almost wasn't even going to show these just because I don't want people to do that and be mad at me. But I do use them on occasion, but very, very rarely. And then another thing I use is a Kratex knife edge wheel. Now, of course, we need a rotary tool. I'm fortunate to have a Fordham, which most people kind of refer to as a Dremel on steroids. But a Dremel will work fine. The Fordham just has more control. So use that, and then we hit it on the buffer real quick. But anyway, those are the tools. So obviously nothing high tech. It's all pretty straightforward. And yeah, let's get going. Everything on this knife is done now, except for the pin and then going around doing the final satin finish around the perimeter of the guard. But like I say, everything else is done. Now I'm kind of made a liar out of myself. I made this thing, which wasn't really all that necessary, but I made it when I was playing around when I got my bigger lathe. But it's just a handle to hold this, and this is a tapered cone diamond burr. Just about any tapered cone burr shaped like this is going to work fine. And I just want to put a little bit of a relief in the outer edges of this hole. And so basically I'm just letting the weight of this thing go down, and then I'm twisting it to cut a little bit of a relief in there. Ream out the end of that hole, and that'll allow a little bit of room for that pin to swell, just a little, and you decrease your chances of this handle material cracking. So then the next thing we need to do is take our pin stock, and I like 416 just because that's what I use for my guards and stuff. I would recommend, if you've never done this and you're wanting to try it, that you do some practice stuff first and try either brass or nickel silver, because they'll move much easier with the hammer blows and polish out easier. The 416 isn't real bad, it's just stiffer than those are. So it's just 416, 16th inch penstock. And the very first thing I do is take it over to a 320 grit belt or disc on a disc center, and just run a nice little chamfer around that, and then take it over and put a mirror polish on the end of it on the buffer.